Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Carell.
Good evening. It is difficult for me to express what a personal thrill it is to pay tribute to Martin Scorsese. Few people in the history of cinema have created such an enduring legacy. His work transcends the craft of filmmaking. Steve Martin is a national treasure. I first saw him perform in 1978. He was little more than a blurry white dot several thousand yards away. But I can tell you what I did see. I saw a man with an arrow through his head. I witnessed the phenomenon of happy feet. I saw a balloon animal depiction of venereal disease. His act was that of an idiot savant, minus the savant. Much of what he did that night could be easily dismissed as abject silliness, pointless clowning, incomprehensible non sequitur. And frankly, that's exactly what I think it was. Because even though I do believe Steve Martin to be a national treasure, in the loosest sense of the term, I also believe that he has deceived us. He has led us to believe that he is both smart and dumb, awkward yet refined, illiterate and yet not illiterate. Perhaps I have chosen an inappropriate time for this. And if I have, well, excuse me. The fact of the matter is that he is even smarter than he is letting on. He is toying with us. Look at him. Look at his face. He's laughing at you. He mocks us for his own personal pleasure. And for this, I think we owe him our thanks. I am in awe of Steve Martin. I admire his career. I respect him more than anyone, with the possible exception of Martin Scorsese. It's truly the greatest honor of my life to pay tribute to you. Our world is richer because you are part of it.
Deep in the heart of Orange County, California, there lived a straight-laced family with a serious little boy who believed in magic, or at least magic tricks. He got his first break at Disneyland, a job at Merlin's Magic Shop. He worked up his magic act, practicing jumps, jokes, and sleight of hand. At 18, he was getting $2 a show, 25 vaudeville shows a week. I had no gifts, he said. I could not sing or dance. My talent was perseverance and naivete. In college, he studied by day and did the comedy clubs at night. He was serious about finding an original way to be funny. He found it in philosophy class. It led me to a sense of the absurd. Absurdity was funny, and no one else was using it. He ripped up his act and started again.
It's the Smothers Brothers.
A television show was looking for young writers. TV was on the straight and narrow. He wasn't. He walked away from his high-paying day job and headed back to the little clubs. I worked up a character, he said, who had total confidence with nothing to back it up.
Hey, this guy is good.
He didn't make jokes. He didn't make sense. But he was fearless.
Excuse me!
Then an invitation to host Saturday Night Live.
Okay, there we go. Uh-oh, I'm getting happy feet. We are two wild and crazy guys. Now when he was a young man, he never thought he'd see people stand in line to see the boy king. How'd you get so funky? Did you do the funky?
He became the rock star of comedy, packing arenas with fans who knew his act by heart. My success outstripped my wildest aspirations, he said. But I had shifted into automatic, and I wasn't being inventive anymore. After 18 years, he closed his prop case and stowed away his magic act for good. He wanted to make an epic, like Dostoevsky's The Idiot, only funnier.
I was born a poor black child.
Grandma! Grandma! What? You got that radio! No, turn it up! Turn it up! This is unbelievable! I've never heard music like this before! It speaks to me! Ah! Yeah, this is unbelievable! Now watch! Now watch!
Yeah?
Well, if this is out there, think how much more is out there! This is the kind of music that tells me to go out there and be somebody!
But Nathan?
There we go.
Thirty-five movies in 25 years.
Half double decaffeinated, half cap, with a twist of lemon.
Marie! I've had my early period and my middle period, he said. And as I enter my late period, I want to find something new worth doing. His plague brought Einstein and Picasso to a Paris cafe and went from Chicago to New York and around the globe. Now this magician holds a pen. Plays, magazines, books. Serious of heart, light of touch, an original imagination. A poet in comics clothing.